guys.
Look at the Savannah Russia. Yeah. We're back at the big trunk, the big log, the big tree. And it's a little bit late in the day, but let's see what we can do. I had to help Mr. Survivor Russia a little bit with some electricity and stuff and stuff. And also, I'm not feeling that awesome actually. Mr. Survivor Russia is not feeling awesome. My little son is semi-ill with the running nose, and the Pink Ninja is also not a too great condition. But Mrs. Survivor Russia, she also had some guests here from the big city, from Moscow. They left yesterday, actually. And yeah, we can always blame it on the guys from the big city, right? So when I'm sort of like in this condition here, with a little bit of a funky throat or something like this, I try to just walk it off or run it off and just stay in the cold. And oftentimes it works. I'm standing here running my mouth. Let's get to it, because we don't have too much time actually. It's the remains of our little fire from yesterday. Awesome. Alright, so our two tools for today is the Silky Big Boy 2000, 6.5 teeth per inch. Then we have the Silky Katana Boy 500 with 5 teeth per inch. So yeah, that should be two pretty alright saws for the task in hand here. So what we're gonna do now is basically to delimb the tree, take off all the branches which are not supporting the log, right? Because you can see the log is off the ground. That means that some of the lower branches is supporting the log, and that is a good thing for now. So yeah, let's get to it. I'll use a Silky Big Boy 2000 to begin with, just to see how it works. So all the branches not supporting the log have been cut, and actually didn't take too long. It took about 22 minutes or something. Yeah, I definitely need to clean the blade when I come home, because there's quite a good amount of resin on it. Pretty neat actually. But what it cuts, it cuts pretty well even. It's soaked in pine resin, so yeah. So what are we gonna do next? I think we're gonna start to divide the log into segments, into pieces, and I will use the Katana Boy 500 for that. I think it took me like 2 minutes or something, and that was with setting cams and everything. So should you ever be in an emergency and need to make a huge, mega Siberian log fire, then I'll show you here how I do it anyway, because it's of course not first time. It's of course not the first time that I do this. So we have the big log laying there, and you can see it's supported on most of these side branches. And we have one there and one over there. Dum dum. And because we have to cut this section here now, it's time to get rid of these two here.
So I cut from the top until the bronze start to bind a little bit. And then I simply just undercut it, just like with a regular chainsaw. And the same over here. So as a guy said, or stated in the comment section, that yeah, if he wanted to go to the forest with a saw, he would take a real carpenter saw or a stiletto saw. And he was laughing at what is these long round handles used for. I think it should be pretty evident, obvious, what they're good for. But my lock nut here have opened up on me. I have noticed that especially the Katana boy has a tendency to loosen up on the locking nut here when cutting a big lumber, or what we can call it, or larger trunks anyway. But it's not worse than you just take the spine off your blade and lock it down, or tighten it down. So that's another fairly good sized cut here. It's not gonna get any easier. Actually, I would prefer to start in the thick end, so the task or the job or the cutting gets easier and easier and easier. I always do that if I have to load firewood or something like this. I always start in the further end, so I have to walk shorter and shorter and shorter. It makes it a little bit funnier, and not funnier, but yeah, it's just how I like to do it. But for this type of logs here, there's no way around it. Not a bad time to get some water, that's for dang sure. My video on the Silky F180, I actually received some flack for that video from different sides and so on. And I completely understand it actually, because it's of course completely incomprehensible, or what is called, non-understandable, that somebody on YouTube could actually promote something for free just for the viewers only. I understand that, because there are so many channels who have wandered off the path and into self-promotion and promotion of this and that, and they're charging huge sums per minute. I know that, but I don't do that. It's not in my interest sphere. Also, you can say, what would my channel be if I did this? If I started to promote all sorts of weird stuff, it would just be just another channel. That's why I'm trying to stay true to the outdoors theme, to the survival theme, to whatever. And when I try and show you guys something, then it's because I think it works. Anyway, it's stuff that works for me, right? So no. To the guy who asked me why I not start to review these and these and these and these and these brand saws, because I don't want to. I don't even review these, I just show you what they can do. And of course, yeah, you can call it review, but anyway, as I said, Silky is not paying me anything for it. Yeah, I got the privilege that I can request some saws from them, and they will most likely send them to me. And I try and request something that you guys can find useful, and that's where the F180, for example, comes in, because it's one of their, if not the absolute cheapest saw that they have, but it still outperforms most other saws, I'd say. And me contacting Silky is not anything new. I did it years ago, a long time ago. I don't even remember when, but it's many years ago. And it's the same with the Siberian Bootmaker Company, and who else? The Hybrid Lights, actually, I also contacted myself. I don't take offers from people who write me, and I get them all the time. You understand? I don't take any of them. Not one. And everybody who's writing me, of all these weird big and small companies, they can testify to that. So you can say circumstance made it that I didn't have too much time here today, but it's Sunday, and it's the beginning tomorrow on a new and awesome week. So we'll go here again and spend the day to get everything set up and stack the firewood and all that good stuff.
We're in a circle at about, I'll say, 80 meters in diameter or something like this. Pretty nice area. So how to plan for a campsite and this and this and that. The fireplace, where should it be, and so on. So first of all, it's of course an awesome idea to find out where do we have the strongest or prevailing winds coming from. The strongest winds, that should be pretty easy to find out, because there we have a fallen tree, there we have a fallen tree, there we have a birch, over there we have another fallen tree, there we have a fallen tree. They're all falling west to east, right? So this is not too much of a rocket science to find out that the most hard winds will come from the west. We'll be having our campsite in there somewhere. In a few hundred meters down there we have a small forest field. Out there we also have an open space, like 100, 200 meters out there. Some of you with trained eyes can see that actually there is an old logging trail there. There's also one over there. And most likely those. There we have three birches. We could principally make a tree stand there. But how useful it will be in here, I don't know. We can take a look down here, further down. There are some awesome places to make tree stands actually. We also have to get out of here because it's getting dark, and it's much darker in real life than on the camera there. Well, we can have some pretty irritating storms during winter from the south. It always comes with a lot of snow. I can find a link to a video up here from stuck in the forest overnight, because I got stuck there and pretty bad snowstorm actually. I didn't realize how bad it was actually. It's never that bad in the forest actually. But it was bad enough that my Siberian log fire was blowing smoke into the shelter all night long, so I actually just had to split the logs out and forget about the fire. It was cold, but manageable. But guys, I'm just rambling and most likely boring you, so yeah, most likely not, maybe not, I don't know. Anyway, guys, check the links in the description and share and subscribe, sub bell, sub like, and please consider supporting the channel. That is always awesome. And until next time, get out on train, get it done, do something awesome, and see you in the next video, guys. Have a great Sunday, and thank you for your time.